नमस्कार, दुरुस्त न्यूज में आप सभी का स्वागत है। गर्मियां बढ़ चुकी हैं, घर से बाहर निकलने का कोई इरादा किसी का भी नहीं है। बाजार तो बहुत दूर की बात है, बाजार से कुछ भी खरीदना हो हम नहीं जाएंगे। घर बैठे बैठे ऑनलाइन शॉपिंग से हम खरीदना ज़्यादा पसंद करते हैं। ये वही ऑनलाइन शॉपिंग नेटवर्क्स हैं जिनकी वजह से हमारे बाजारों की जो रौनक है वो कहीं दूर चली गई है। वो छुटपुट जो विक्रेता थे वो अपनी अपनी दुकानें बंद कर कर इन्हीं ऑनलाइन शॉपिंग के साथ जुड़ना ज़्यादा पसंद कर रहे हैं, यानी मजबूर हो रहे हैं इनके साथ हाथ मिलाने के लिए। क्या आपको लगता है जो कुछ भी आप खरीदते हैं इस ऑनलाइन शॉपिंग से वो आप तक पहुंचता है? जितने भी जो सेलर्स हैं, क्या ये सही हैं या फिर गलत हैं? कई ऐसे लोग हैं जो अच्छा बिजनेस करते हैं, साफ तौर पर बिजनेस करते हैं आपके साथ। आप जो भी ऑर्डर करते हैं वो समय से पहले आप तक पहुंच जाता है एक अच्छे डिस्काउंट के साथ, जो अच्छी बात है। उसके उलट काफ़ी सारे ऐसे भी सेलर्स इधर आ चुके हैं जो सिर्फ आपको लूटना चाहते हैं, और इस लूटपाट पर अमेज़न आपका कोई साथ नहीं देता है। सवाल यहाँ पे आता है, जब एक महीने या फिर दो महीने एक इंसान अपने प्रोडक्ट का इंतज़ार करता है, उसको नहीं मिलता है, तो क्यों एक सेलर के ऊपर पेनल्टी नहीं लगाई जाती है इन लोगों के द्वारा, और क्यों वो दोबारा इसी हरकत को करने के लिए वहाँ पे उस प्लेटफॉर्म पे रहता है? यानी एक ऐसा सेलर है जिसका नाम है UTI, जो 12 महीने से लोगों को लूट रहा है, बेवकूफ़ बना रहा है, ऑर्डर्स वो आपसे ले लेता है और आपको झूठे वायदे पे घुमाता रहता है महीने दो महीने तक, और एक अचानक से दिन वो आपको ईमेल करना बंद कर देता है। उसका मोड ऑफ ऑपरेंडी यही है कि आपसे ऑर्डर तो वो ले लेगा लेकिन आप तक सामान कभी नहीं पहुंचाएगा। इस संदर्भ में हमने भी कुछ एक इन्वेस्टिगेशन करी, जिसका पूरा का पूरा कॉल रिकॉर्ड, कॉल डिटेल और किस तरह से हमने ये इस पूरे स्कैम को उजागर करने की कोशिश करी है, वो तमाम चीजें इस ऑडियो रिकॉर्डिंग में है। पहले आप इस ऑडियो को सुने, उसके बाद हम वापस आपसे बात करते हैं।
शक्ति, हाय, दिस इज राहुल कॉलिंग फ्रॉम द रूस्ट न्यूज। Shakti, we have been getting a lot of, we were tracking on the story for the last one couple of months, and we firstly placed an order from a so-called seller called UTI, and the order was placed on 7th of April, and 8th of April we got a message by saying it has been dispatched, and we will be receiving our order between 19th and 29th of April. We waited till last minute, and in between we tried messaging the seller by to release the tracking details, as we already knew about the history of the seller. He had messaged us one on 19th of April, second one was on 21st of April. Both the times he didn't release any tracking details, right? And he said on 21st email that between 48 hours it will be cleared from Delhi Customs department. They have filed all the paperwork, and within 72 hours I will be receiving my product, right?
Okay.
For which we waited till 29th. On 30th morning we called your customer care. There was a specific response and support from your end. I'm sorry to say this, but yes, this is what we have gone through. The first lady officer who spoke to me, she said she is escalating the issue. We wrote a nice review on this. Yesterday, I got a reply from Amazon by saying we cannot post this review due to certain reasons. Okay, so our review got rejected from Amazon side, not by the seller side. It was through Amazon side. So this is what the whole story is. But now the real fact is UPI and X Border. There are two sellers, right? And they both have very, very X Border and UTI store. It is 93% negative feedbacks, right? Seller is there for more than 1 year. Okay? People are regularly escalating their issues with the seller. They are contacting Amazon on a very, very regular basis. Like every day, between 5 to 25 complaints are being registered at your page. You know, and there are so many people like us, their reviews are getting rejected, right? And everyone has the same issue that they had not got the delivery yet. There are two people who are waiting more than 2 months. There are people who paid the money and they are still waiting for their refund. There are people who have bought 3 numbers and they just got 1 number. There are people who have bought a different product and they received a different product, you know. And which you have seen out of 202 comments, right, only 18% is what your page says it is a positive thing. That means only out of 100, only 9 people would have got their product or they said it is good. So 91 people are saying no, they have been cheated. And
for which seller you are speaking about?
UTL, U2i store as well as Xborder. Both have the same story. And we have discovered lot more people, like people are there in the same fashion. So our question is, when people are raising their voice for the last 1 year and plus, why Amazon was quiet on them? Even today, the same product, if I have to buy it again, I have an option of going and buying with the same seller. You know, there is no filter. I can simply go and buy it again and wait for another 25 days and this seller will be expanded. 1 case, 2 case, 3 case, 10 case is okay, madam. But just imagine 93% cases.
Sir, actually, yeah, I can take the feedback, okay. But regarding the other customer's views, I will not be able to comment on that, okay.
Okay, so this, see, my question is, if you find this kind of seller, how can he is doing business regularly for the last 1 year and plus with Amazon, and Amazon had not taken any action till date?
Sir, we do have a separate team working for sellers. Okay. And that team, that concerned team, are bound to abide for some rules. Okay. It is not like that customer comes and gives complaint on the seller. They can fire out the seller. Okay. They do have some set of rules. Okay. If those rules are met, back-end rules are met, yeah, because that seller will be existing in Amazon. Just because customer, only because customer reviews, seller is not with Amazon, actually.
So, seller can be...
It is up to the customer.
Seller can be a fraud. He will not deliver the product and Amazon will still continue to do business with him. So, for Amazon, customer is important, or a seller who has a very, very negative background?
Sir, you cannot tell that seller is fraud just because not delivering his product for only some set of customers.
Okay. Madam, 93% is some for you. Out of 100, 93% is some for you. This is what you mean to say?
We do have back-end team working on it. For example, I'm telling you, if a customer is posting a review stating that the product was not delivered, but it is marked as delivered, the product did not deliver, seller did not deliver. He's posting a review such. So, our back-end team will work on it, okay? They will get in touch with the seller and everything. Seller will give all the proofs stating that the customer got the product. In this case, we cannot...
So you mean to say the seller is right, 93% of customers who have come across and... No, that is what it is, madam. Like, you mean to say... Madam, let me finish. You mean to say that 93% of the customers are wrong. One person who is a seller, you will not stop doing business with him. He will continue to stay on Amazon platform. He will continue to not deliver the product on time or never after taking the money. And you say the seller is right and people are wrong.
Sir, my first statement was, I cannot comment on the reviews of the other customers because we are in conversation. I can only comment on your reviews, not the other customers' reviews. Okay? I'm not here to comment on other customers' reviews.
Okay, fine. Let us take it in this way. I am the customer. Yeah. Okay, let me take it on me. What we have ordered on 7th, right?
Okay.
For which the seller sent a message that it has been dispatched, right?
Okay.
Till 29th, the seller did not reveal any tracking details, right? The customer, that means me, is being continuously following up on seller end, Amazon end, both the same. That please give us some details. Seller did not release any details till then, right? customer had waited till 29th, which was the last day, evening. Next day morning, when he contacts the customer care, which is from today, 4 days back, right? Till today, Amazon team had not given me any clear picture that where is the seller, where is his communication, where is the tracking detail, where is my product, nothing. You are point zero. You are blank point zero in replying me any of my questions. Now I'm not, I let us forget about 93% who had written negative feedback. Maybe they are enemies to the seller. That is what they have come and written something like this. Let me take myself here. I don't know about the seller.
Yeah, perfect, sir. We talk about your issue.
So let me finish, no? So I waited from 7th of April till 4th of May, which is almost 1 month. Today, your officer calls me after so much of callings and all those things that seller is not traceable. Seller is not traceable. He is not replying to any of our queries, right?
Okay.
So when the seller is not traceable, we are ready to refund. But the seller still exists in Amazon platform. You know, for other things, for to do trading, to sell his product, to do all stuff, he's there. He's there in Amazon page. But to reply to a customer, to reply to your officer, he's not available. Right? How can you continue to do business and you don't have any proof or any details about the seller, or you don't have any hold on the seller that he can do anything in this space, and you are not responsible? The sufferer is only the customer, and that too when the customer had paid well in advance for your kind information. The seller doesn't take any this pay on delivery. So now today, on the 4th day, like 29th ke baad, today is the 4th day. Today, after so many calls, after so many follow-ups, there is a person from your end who comes and offers me that, sir, we can pay you the whole amount. You know, the full refund will come. Definitely, you have to pay me the full money. So, where is this full refund comes? Huh? And what about my 1 month investment? The time which I was waiting that this product will come.
Let me speak, sir. Shall I?
Yeah, please go ahead.
We'll go by facts itself, sir. Facts, yeah. And terms and conditions itself, because our conversation is like that only.
Yes.
About seller fulfill orders, okay? About seller fulfill orders, we have very clearly given in the terms and conditions. If you want, I'll guide you through the terms and conditions, okay? Amazon is not directly involved in the completion of sales for seller fulfilled orders, and Amazon does not take responsibility for the seller fulfilled orders. Okay, and that is why the reason for each and every product, whatever the product you pick in Amazon, there will be a tagline stating this, sold and fulfilled by, sold by some seller name, fulfilled by some seller name. If sold and fulfilled by Amazon, if it is fulfilled by Amazon products, Amazon takes the responsibility. All these terms and conditions which we have posted in our web page itself. Okay, so that the customer can decide it is a seller product, Amazon will not be responsible, can we go ahead and place an order or not. Okay, and the other thing is, if the product is not delivered or else if the seller is not responding, after the customer pays to the seller, if the product is not getting delivered, whatever, if the seller is not responding, damaged, defective, whatever the issue is, first thing is, we'll contact the seller. If the seller is not responding within the timeline what we have given to you, okay, there is a separate team which is called A to Z guarantee team for some set of orders, okay? A to Z guarantee team, we can file a claim on the seller, okay? So that team will get in touch with the seller for the refund or as a product delivery if it is not getting delivered, okay? So depending upon, they will check with the seller. If the seller is feasible, if the seller is okay, agreeing for the refund, whatever it is, okay? Whatever the seller replies, we will give back to the customer. If the seller is not responding, we'll refund to the customer. Okay? In your case, if the seller is not responding, obviously he's not responding, okay? We cannot ask you to wait till the seller is responding, okay? So, we are providing you the money what you have paid. We do not take the responsibility first, but it is you have placed the order through Amazon site. Okay. Finally, we should be responsible for your money at least, not regarding the delivery and all.
Okay.
But and final step, if you're not getting the delivery, at least you want to get your money back. For that, we are responsible all the time. Okay, about your money back. So we are ready to ship the refund what you have paid.
Okay. Now let me come on to the same thing. What you said, you are clearly mentioning that this is not Amazon sold and fulfilled product. This is a seller fulfilled product. Okay. So definitely you have certain rules and regulations for the seller also. That if so many times, listen to me, ma'am. When you speak, I have not uttered a word. When I'm speaking, please allow me to. Then, let us have this decency of listening to each other without interrupting each other. Then, great. So, seller, you, as you said, as per your thing, that seller fulfilled by Amazon is separate, and seller fulfilled by the seller is separate thing. You know, for Amazon thing, you take responsibility, and for the seller thing, you don't take responsibility, but the money part, you take responsibility that you will at least get the refund, right? Okay. Now, we'll come on the seller sold and fulfilled product as we what we purchase. If the seller is repeatedly doing the same mistake again and again with every order, you know, with almost every order, right, does Amazon takes any action against the seller?
We do take action, but from my end, my level, I will not be knowing what is that action. Okay, we have a separate team for that. That team will take care of. Even I will not be having those information. We do take information. We do take action. That information I have. What kind of action? What will be the final decision? Everything, we have a separate team for that. They will take care of.
Okay.
We just pass the feedbacks to the concerned team. That's it.
When you are saying we don't know,
it's not possible that every team should know every other team's policy guidelines and what they are doing.
Got it. Sorry. Yeah. You don't know what happens on the other department. But do you realize the dangerous situation what every customer goes through on this? Where he sees a product, immediately he likes that product, or he is in need of that product, he immediately buys. Okay? And then after waiting for a month, he feels cheated because the person through whom he bought, he says, no, you didn't bought it from me, you bought it from an X person. So, we will escalate the issue to the X person, and the X person will tell us what to do next, you know. So, the X person is the seller. The place where we bought it is you, Amazon, right? So, when the Amazon don't have any hold on the seller, and Amazon had not done anything in the past 1 year, how customer can rely or trust on Amazon further, you know, then we have to keep checking, okay, is this Amazon fulfilled order, then we should buy this. This is not, let us not buy. So there are so many good sellers, they will be affected, correct? There are so many good sellers, like we have been buying products from Amazon for so many days, and there are more than 80% of people are outside Amazon fulfilled orders. Right. We post it, we buy today and tomorrow, the product is there. And there are few people like this also. That means we should not buy anything beyond which is fulfilled by Amazon. This is what I can understand from what being a customer care officer, that to heading the customer care team says.
Sir, exactly.
Because you said no, that, yeah, because you cannot take any responsibility of anything which Amazon is not which is not Amazon fulfilled order. So it is at customer's risk. You want to buy, otherwise no.
Exactly, that is what the point is.
Okay, great. So great, so we'll go ahead on this news, madam. So what we'll do is we'll tell people that please, whatever you buy only Amazon fulfilled order, otherwise please don't even think about buying anything which is available in Amazon, which is not fulfilled by Amazon, because that is that risk you are taking. If you don't get, then you have to just do the same thing what we have done, we have been doing for the last 4 days.
It is already given in the web page itself, sir.
Yes, ma'am. So we will escalate it. We will make people understand more in deep how people should come on Amazon and what all things they should buy and what all things they should avoid buying. Thank you so much for explaining
exactly, because customer
right?
wants to know what
yeah,
to
get
in the
so thank you so much to supporting these kind of sellers. And please, our best wishes so that you can get a lot more sellers like UT, One and X Border.
यकीनन आपने ये ऑडियो सुन लिया होगा और आपको ये समझ भी आ गया होगा कि जिस कंपनी पर हम आंख मूंद कर भरोसा करते हैं, सामान खरीदते हैं, वो अंत में जब इस तरह के सेलर्स के साथ डील करते हैं तो आपको कितनी तकलीफ पहुंचती है, आप एक तरह से खुद को ठगा हुआ महसूस करते हैं। हम ये चाहते थे कि अमेज़न इसके ऊपर किस तरह की कार्रवाई करता है। यकीनी तौर पर आपने भी सुना होगा कि अमेज़न इस पर किसी भी तरह की कार्रवाई नहीं कर रहा है, यानी आज भी ये सेलर अमेज़न के प्लेटफॉर्म पे है, आज भी ये सेलर अमेज़न के साथ बिजनेस कर रहा है, आज भी ये सेलर हिंदुस्तान के लोगों को ठग रहा है, लूट रहा है, और जिसका साथ अमेज़न दे रहा है। आशा करते हैं कि आपकी जो शॉपिंग है वो वापस बाजारों की तरफ रुख करेगी, हमारे जो बाजार ढल से गए हैं, हमारे जो बाजारों से जो रोशनी है, जो रंगीनियत थी वो चली सी गई है, वो आपकी वजह से दोबारा से वापस आएगी। वो जो छोटे मोटे विक्रेता थे जो बाजार छोड़ के कहीं और जा चुके हैं, वो वापस वहाँ पे आएंगे और आपके लिए अच्छे से अच्छा, बेहतर से बेहतर सामान मुहैया कराएंगे। मज़ा बाजार में जाके शॉपिंग करने का ही है, इस तरह से ऑनलाइन शॉपिंग का मज़ा किरकिरा हो जाता है। बने रहे हमारे साथ दुरुस्त न्यूज़, जो आपको तमाम खबरें दिखाता है जो सीधे आपकी जड़ों से जुड़ी हुई होती हैं। सब्सक्राइब जरूर करें ताकि आपको तमाम खबरें मिलती रहें जो हम सिर्फ और सिर्फ आपके लिए बनाते हैं। धन्यवाद।